Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how we can perform string concatenation in C language. So before start, I just want to share one information. If you go to detail or description of this video, so you will find links of various playlists related to C language, so you can follow them. Now I am going to start my explanation. So in this video, I will explain you string concatenation logic. So I am not going to use strcat, that is predefined function, but I will tell you how this strcat concatenate two strings. So I will be explaining that logic with the help of loops. So here you can see two strings are available, s1 and s2. S1 is having my first name and s2 is having my last name. So I need to concatenate both, and the concatenated result will be available into s1 string. So what I am going to do, I am going to remove this null from here, and I will be placing one space in place of this null character. And after this, here on 7th index, this G will be copied, then U, P, T, A, and then at last it will be having null character, right? So before starting the build of logic, I am just writing initial statement, so that you will get to know how we can read two strings from user. So first of all, I'm going to write name and then two strings S1 and S2. Then I'm going to declare two variables, I and C. Then a printf statement which will display a message. Enter first string, so to read that string I'm using getters, so getters S1 will read that string. Then again one more printf, enter second string, or in this case we can also write here enter first name, enter last name. So this depend upon you what you write in printf. So this way, with these statements, I am able to read a value of S1 and S2 from user. Now, first I need to rotate a loop so that I can move to this null position of S1 string, right? So for this purpose, I am going to write a loop which is starting from 0. Its condition is this: S1 of I not equals to null, and then I plus plus. So if this condition is true, then this loop will repeat and it will be incrementing value of C by 1. So initially I is 0, check this condition, S1 of 0 not equals to null. So S1 of 0 position is having S, which is not equals to null. So C will be incremented by 1. So I'm writing logic here. So when we are on this position S, so C will be 1. When we are on A position, C will become 2. When we are on N, C will be 3. If we are on J, C will be 4. If we are on 5, if we are on A, C will be 5. When we are on Y, C will become 6. Then I will be pointing to this position, null. And in that case, you need to check this condition. So in that case, this condition will be false and this loop will be terminated. So after rotation of this complete loop, you can see final value of C is 6. Final value of C is 6, which is the last position, or you can say null position of S1 string. And we need to identify that position only, because we need to remove null from S1 and we need to place a blank space on that position. So after completion of this loop, I can write this: S1 of C equals to space. So in single quotes, I mentioned the space. So S1 string C index, that is 6. So it will be having a blank space. So null will be removed and it will be having a blank space, right? Now I need to implement one more loop that will repeat according to S2. So I will repeat a loop starting from 0 to null position, and I will copy one by one each character to these positions, right? So this time I need to start from here. from seventh index, because on sixth index I have already stored space. So after putting this space, I am again incrementing value of C. So this time C will become 7. So current value of C is 7. Now I am going to implement one more loop, that is I equals to 0. S2 not equals to null is the condition, and then I plus plus. So here you can see I have used S2 of I. So now loop will depend upon this string. So if null is not available, then it will repeat. If null is available, it will be terminated. And I need to copy value of S2 into S1. So right hand side contained will be copied at right left hand side position. So S2 of I value will be copied to S1 of C position. And then I am going to increase value of C. Right? So now I am going to iterate this. So initially I is 0. Check this condition. S2 of 0 not equals to null, true, because S2 of 0 is having G. Then S2 of 0 will be copied to S1 of C. So what is the latest value of C? So 6, and then we incremented 7. So latest value of C is 7. So S1, 7 position will be having S2 of 0 position value. So G will be copied here. G will be copied here. Then C will be incremented to 8. Then I will be incremented to 1. And check this. S2 of 1 position, that is U, which is not equals to null. So again it is true. S1 of 1 position will be copied to S1 of 8th index, because right now C is 8. So U will be copied here. Then C will be incremented to 9, and I will be incremented to 2. So C incremented, I incremented. Now check second index value, that is P not equals to null. So P will be copied to S1 at C index. So P will be copied here. Then again C will be incremented, I will be incremented. So check third index of S2. It is having T, which is not equals to null. So T will be copied again, and it will become 11, and it will become 4. So S2 of 4 index will be copied to S1 of 11. So A will be copied, then it will become 12, and it is 5. So S2 of 5 index is having null. So null not equals to null. This time this condition is false. It means null will not be copied, and this loop will be terminated. And the final value of C is 12. Now at 12 index, at this position, we need to insert a black, sorry, we need to insert a null character, because if we don't insert null, then S1 will not become a string. So after completion of this loop, I am putting this. S1 of C index will be having null. So S1 of C is 12. So 12 index will be having null. So this way you can see both strings are concatenated into S1. It is also having a blank space, and then last name, then null character. Now after this, you can use a printf, and you can print the result like this and close the main. So this way you saw how I implemented the logic. So first I find out the last position or null position of S1. Then I placed space. Then I copied second string into first string at the end. And then I printed the output that is available in S1. So this way I explained you how we can concatenate two strings in C language. I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. And if you want to watch more programming related videos, open my channel, go to playlist and see various videos there. Also, you can go to detail or description of this video. So there I have pasted links of all the playlists related to C language. So you can follow them as well. So thank you for watching this video.